Hi everyone, my name is Nick Chanel. I'm the former Chief Software Officer for the Air Force and Space Force. Today we're going to talk about modern cyber posture with the three pillars to be able to move at a pace relevant with baked-in security. All right, I'm going to ask you to close your eyes and imagine a world where critical vulnerabilities are released multiple times a day, if not hours. Imagine a world where patching must happen in production within hours, if not minutes. Imagine a world when software and hardware can be decoupled. And while your hardware might be stuck in time, your software can be released multiple times a day with new features and, more importantly, updated over the air. Imagine a world where you can have a full digital twin representation of your system. And that twin enables you to know exactly how your system is going to behave before even bending metal. Well, it's time to open your eyes and wake up, because guess what? This happened back in 2014 when Tesla released its software over the update capability. So if your organization has yet to understand how critical everything we just talked about is and the game-changing capabilities we mentioned, it's a miracle you're still in business. But worse, if you do not take action now, whether it's a matter of days, weeks, months, or if you're lucky, years, you're going to be out of business then. Now, if you implement DevSecOps, this is going to enable you to move at a pace relevant and deliver capabilities in the hands of your end user multiple times a day and with baked-in security. Now, let's take a look at the three pillars for modern cyber posture. The first pillar is moving target defense. Cattle versus pet. We talked about cattle versus pet in a previous video, but pretty much what that means is a virtual machine, you give it a name, you care for it, you don't want it to die, you want to heal it if there's a problem. That's pets. Cattle is a container. You go shoot it behind the barn every 4 hours and move on. That creates the concept of immutable state and continuously going back to immutable state every 4 hours. That is moving target defense. Your entire infrastructure, platform, and application becomes cattle. Effectively, that prevents malicious actor to retain that foothold in your system if they manage to get in. Additionally, everything is code. We use the concept of Git Ups. We're going to do a full video on Git Ups as well. Infrastructure as code, configuration as code, is replicable, immutable, automated, no human in production to make sure we mitigate that insider threat and mistakes being made, but more importantly, no drift in production. GitOps is a foundation. Your source code becomes your crown jewel. And please, pull, don't push. Now, we have the second pillar, zero trust. Zero trust became a bloated term. We're going to make a dedicated video on it as well. But effectively, zero trust is both the enforcement of the device state and identity using strong identity and looking at the device state, patching, updates, and whether or not it's using a proper endpoint protection capability. But then you also have the user identity using multi-factor authentication, and we're looking at the component risk of the device use and the user risk, and the component risk is what defines what kind of access you're going to get. So if I use a government device with my account, or if I use a non-government device with my account, I get access to different things. The identity also are not just for people, but also for non-person entities, NPEs, microservices, systems talking to each other as well. The entire traffic east-west is limited to only what is whitelisted by using the concept of micro-segmentation and what we call software-defined perimeter, SDP, not SDN, very different. SDP will also enforce the device state as well. Effectively, each combination of a device and a user have a dedicated segment of one. It's a dedicated network, so malicious actors cannot laterally move between networks. On top of that, you can add a service mesh, and the service mesh will help you also prevent lateral movement between container A and container B, for example. That traffic would have to be whitelisted for the traffic to flow. Now, the third pillar is continuous monitoring with behavior prevention. DevSecOps, not just DevOps. The difference between DevSecOps and DevOps is not just I'm going to do some static and dynamic code analysis on my source code. The SEC is effectively the fact that your DevSecOps platform also runs in runtime in production. It is not just a development platform. What that means is the continuous monitoring in your cyber stack enforcement and all three pillars are part of your DevSecOps platform as a foundation for everything else. We leverage continuous monitoring with behavior prevention using AI and ML capabilities. It's going to continuously monitor the containers and proactively kill them if they drift in behaviors. It doesn't just focus on CV scanning. Of course, we still do CV scanning as well, but it's also looking at the software bill of material and the provenance and integrity of these containers as well, using signatures with tools like CoSigned and Sigstore. Here we have it, three pillars: moving target defense, zero trust, continuous monitoring with behavior prevention. That drastically reduces your attack surface. First, by using the concept of cattle, you go back to immutable state and you make sure that the malicious actors don't retain access to your system. With zero trust, you mitigate the lateral movement between your systems and containers and different services. With continuous monitoring, you're gonna continuously look at the behavior of the containers and proactively kill them when they start drifting in behavior, minimizing the ability of malicious actor to start infiltrating your system as well. With those combined, you get the strongest cyber posture you can get. Now you've seen it. By enabling DevSecOps and following the three pillars, you can now move at the pace of relevance. But don't forget, you also have that baked-in security to enable it. Thanks for watching, and please subscribe, click on the little bell, and we'll see you in the next video.